Hi, I'm Dr. Amy Wasserbauer. I'm a licensed clinical psychologist. I'm an assistant director and clinical lead of counseling services.
Hello, my name is Carrie Monica, assistant director in ASU counseling services. So I think about the stress continuum as in the shape of a bell. There's sort of a process or trajectory of what happens with stress, going from stress to distress.
On each side of the continuum of stress, it's flatline. We don't want to really live that way. We want to start with what this side of the bell curve is eustress, E-U-S-T-R-E-S-S. I will spell it because often we don't hear about eustress, which is truly defined as good stress. In order to really cope with stress the best, we have to understand this continuum. At the top of the bell curve is stress itself, and then as you come down the other side is distress. And that can flatline you to just shut down. If you don't have any energy or movement to have any kind of stress, if you're like, oh, I can never have stress, you can shut down on the other side. We don't want to be shut down as humans because we want to be functional. We want our students to be able to be successful at ASU. And so we want them to learn how to handle the full continuum of stress.
When you get to kind of towards the top, you're getting into this orange-red zone. And so this is where distress is about to kick in. It's not quite distress, but it's kicking in there. And meaning that things are getting, the workload is heavier for students. And this is when finals and exams, you know, if you're a leader in a student organization, this is where special events and activities and projects are coming up. Navigating those social waters and trying to balance work, life, school. If a student has a job, that's again where that's another factor or responsibility that's compounded in terms of managing life as a student.
So it's naming it and allowing it in the context to say, what do I need to do to care for myself? So during midterms, do I stay on Netflix for 12 hours? Or do I find a balance of what's helping me relax for a little bit, but also getting sleep, allowing me to self-care, to eat well, to not skip meals while I'm studying, to not forget that I'm a human that needs to get rest. And in that acceptance of that self-care, stress can lower, but we still own their stress. Don't rescue, listen. And that's all I can really accentuate is ask them how they're doing, what are they doing to get help and support, you being a listening ear, not telling them what to do, but really listening, letting them know you hear them, but put back on them what they need to do. Where do you need to go at ASU for more support? Is there, are you a freshman and you have a first year success coach and you need to contact your first year success coach? Do you have an academic advisor you need to talk to about what you're dealing with? Our tutoring center, oh my goodness, so much support that way. But you're giving them direction to make adult decisions, because even though it may feel like it's overwhelming, you're helping them learn that they're capable.
What's really important for parents too is just to be in tune to your own level of stress about how you feel about your child and their transition into college or their existence in college, and really being in tune to your own feelings and emotions around that. And so stopping and sometimes asking yourself, is this my issue and my worry and stress that's mine to own? Or is this really something that's actually happening with my child or student that I need to address? And so just some of that own intuition and insight into your own emotions and feelings surrounding stress. Finances, college degree, political affiliations, social choices. There's a lot of changes for students, and so really allowing them to embrace those changes they're going through, so that if you don't disagree with them, that it doesn't become stressful for them that you disagree with them. And so maybe having some of those conversations, but again, honoring that they are making their own unique choices for themselves as young adults. You know, just the number of student organizations that exist at ASU is tremendous. And so there is a student club and organization for every single student. So getting on Sun Devil Sync, typing in those keywords that help you to search for certain topics of interest, and that way you find that group that you're interested in. And so just checking out meetings, there's no commitment. Student organization clubs, and they're just so welcoming and fantastic to any new members. And so just check a meeting out. There's no commitment. What's good about being connected to other organizations is that you'll meet other students who are then connected to other things as well. And so they can give you some suggestions or share some experience that they've had in other organizations based on your interest that you may not even know about.
What the university offers through our student engagement area, through our wellness department, ASU Wellness offers many supports for prevention of going to that distressed place. We want to support our students when they're not, again, in that distressed place. Our Sun Devil Fitness and Wellness Center offers many ways to help our students de-stress way before they're distressed. As well, we also have the ASU Center for Mindfulness, Compassion, and Resilience. Students can be able to learn ways of coping and grounding themselves in the midst of anxiety that they feel. They will feel it. We can't fix that. We want them to learn to feel it and cope. Family members, also really encourage your student to get social support in ways that they are not isolating, in ways that they are not being lone rangers, because we know as humans that it's so important to connect. We know that's been a challenge. Social support is another part of helping students be successful. Connecting, finding peers, finding friendships throughout college.
If you're a parent of a current high school student, everything that I've shared and throughout these series of video chats all applies to even incoming high school students. And so similar to what I mentioned earlier was, you know, help your student with doing some research and what they're interested in, what schools they're interested in going to, but actually come to the campuses, walk around, check it out. Do some of that work on the front end. Don't wait till their senior year to help them with figuring out how to integrate themselves into college. Having those discussions and really exploring, you know, what they're interested in. But talking about those things related to mental health and social well-being for college is, you know, what will that look like for you? How will you know when you're not doing well? Where can you go get help? When should you reach out to us as your parents? Encouraging that wellness component of mental and physical health even before they get to college.